What's up, my wonderific PD peeps? Today, I'm going to show you how to make a fade to black transition using the PowerDirector Video Editor app. If you're new to my channel and you want to learn how to use PowerDirector, click the subscribe button and click on the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. The fade to black transition does just what it says. It fades from a video clip or an image to a black screen. It can be used at the beginning, the end, or the middle of clips. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make the fade to black transition for your videos. Let's fade to Blizzak. As you can see, I have two clips on my timeline, and I want to fade to black at the beginning, in the middle, and at the end. First thing that you need to do is bring a black color board to the overlay track. So you want to tap on the overlay icon. Then you want to tap on the image tab. You want to tap on color board. You want to tap the black color board and you want to tap the plus sign and it'll add it to your timeline right where your playhead is. Now you want to go ahead and make sure that the color board fills out the whole screen. So we'll tap on the color board and we can see that it's just in the middle. So in order to fill out the whole screen, you want to place two fingers on the screen and you want to pinch this out until it covers the entire screen. Next thing that you want to do is you want to change the length or the duration of the color board to something that fits for you. For me, I'm going to use 3 seconds. So I'm just going to hold my finger over this edge here where the trim line is, this white line at the end. And I'm going to trim this down until it says 3 seconds. And then I'll let go. Now what we need to do is add some opacity. And we're going to use keyframes to create a fade from black to the clip. So let's go ahead and tap on opacity. Then you want to move your playhead all the way to the beginning. And here you want to add a keyframe. So tap on this little diamond here and it'll add a keyframe and lock it in at 100, which you can see is on the slider here on the right. Then you want to move your playhead to the last frame. So we know it's 3 seconds long. So I'm going to go to 3 seconds. And here you want to go ahead and tap on the keyframe diamond again. But this time you want to bring your slider down to 0. So what that does is it creates a fade. So if I slide this back and if I play this, you'll see that it's going to fade from black to the clip. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Now we want to go ahead and create a fade to black between the two clips. So we're going to have to bring a color board onto the main track this time. So we're going to go ahead and tap on the media icon. And then we'll tap on the image tab. We'll tap on color board. And then we'll tap the black color board and we'll tap the plus sign. And went ahead and added that black color board to the end of the timeline. So you want to hold your finger over this black color board and press until you see this little yellow border and then drag it over until you see a yellow line in between the two clips. Let it go, and it'll go ahead and place that black color board right in between the two clips for you. So the next thing you want to do is you want to trim this down so it's 3 seconds as well. So we're going to go ahead and tap on that clip. We're going to put our finger over this line at the end, and we're going to drag this down. And that should be good right there. Now, because we have transitions in between these two clips, we're going to go ahead and utilize those to create the fade. So let's go ahead and tap on this first transition box. And then we'll go ahead and tap on the fade transition. And then we'll tap on the second transition box and we'll tap on the fade transition again. Now what this does is it creates a fade from the clip to the color board and then another fade from the color board to the clip. So it's going to look like it fades to black and then it fades from black to the clip. So let's play this back and I'll show you what I'm talking about.
Beautiful.
Last but not least, we want to go ahead and create a fade at the end. So we're going to go back and add a color board to the overlay track just like we did before. So let's go ahead and tap on the overlay icon. We'll tap on the image tab. We'll tap on color board. We'll tap the black color board and we'll tap the plus sign. Now I added it where the playhead is, but that's not where I want it. So I'm going to go ahead and hold it down until I see that yellow border. I'm going to drag it to the end. And then I'm going to go ahead and tap on it. pinch it out to resize it, make sure it covers the whole screen. Then I'm gonna go ahead and place my finger over this trim line and I'm gonna trim this back so that it's only 3 seconds. And now I'll go ahead and hold my finger over it again. And I'm gonna drag it right to the end of this clip. So I'm gonna go ahead and use opacity again to create the fade. So this time I'm gonna go ahead and tap on the clip. And I'm gonna tap on opacity. Now this time, where the first keyframe is, we want it to be at zero. So I'm gonna go ahead and tap on the keyframe diamond and I'm gonna drag the slider down to zero because we want the clip to show at this point and we want it to transition to being black. So now I'm gonna move my playhead to the end of the clip and I'm gonna tap on the keyframe diamond again. And this time I'm gonna move it up to 100 so that at the end it's black. So if we play this back now, it should go from the clip to black.
Fade to Blizzak.
If you like what you see, I'll leave a link to trial PowerDirector Mobile in the video description. I know you want more PowerDirector love, so be sure to click on these videos to watch more of my content and smash my logo to subscribe. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below.